for our examples and demonstrations today, we're going to assume that we're a coffee shop, and we're going to program a few items in that a typical coffee shop would have in their system. And to start that process, we're going to go up here to the Manager button, and that's going to bring up what we call our control panel. And this control panel really has all of the back office features and functions that we're typically going to use for our configuration and setup. In order to get started here, we actually want to create a few departments. In order to do that, let's go ahead and start by finding category number 5 down here, which is administrative, and then going to letter B for department maintenance. And this is going to bring up our department maintenance screen. We're going to start by adding we're going to click the Add Department button, and we're going to be prompted to input the department ID and a department description. For our purposes, these two are going to be spelled exactly the same way. What can happen sometimes is that the department ID is an abbreviated form. There can only really be 8 characters in that field. The department description can be a longer description for you. And in both of these, you just want to be careful not to use dots, slashes, hashes, dashes, question marks, those sorts of characters. We want to keep these to strictly alphanumeric characters. Now that we've created our coffee department, we're going to click Save. And the system's going to ask if we want to create another department. We're going to go ahead and say yes, we're going to make another department here. And let's save that one as well. This time we're going to say no to creating any additional departments. And if we'd like to see the departments we've created, the ones that are already here in the system, let's click the Lookup button down below, and this will show us a list of departments. If we wanted to hop back over and change a description, we can click one of them and press select. That's going to bring that department up for us to do a few minor modifications. Now, some customers do want to change the department ID on these departments once they create them, and that's just not possible. So if you really need to fundamentally change the department, you might want to just add a new one before we get into the actual menu programming. But now that we're done with this, let's click exit. And we're going to go ahead, jump right in, and create what we call a standard item, which is just a typical item that the cashier might want to order for a customer. To do that, we're going to stay here on the administrative section number 5. We're going to go to letter A, which is inventory maintenance. Now, when we get to this screen, you'll see the next and previous button here allow us to kind of hop through the different records of items that are already programmed into the system. And what we're going to do for right now is we're going to click the Add Item button that's going to let us start this process. We're going to pick from a list of options here what kind of item we want to add. In this case, standard items, definitely what we're trying to do. And the first thing we want to check here is we want to make sure that our department that the item is going to be created in is selected correctly. We just made the coffee department, so let's go ahead and select that department from the drop-down, and now we're sure that this item is going to be programmed and inserted into the coffee department. Now, for this one, let's call it a cafe latte. Again, just like with the department IDs, when we get to the item number and description, we have the same kind of situation. Item numbers we want to limit to approximately 14 characters max. And with the description, we're going to have a longer entry that we can put in, approximately 32 characters if we'd like. As with the departments, we want to just keep that to alphanumeric characters only. We don't want any dots, slashes, hashes, those sorts of things in the input for either one of these, item number or description. Now we're going to come over to the pricing information, and we're going to go ahead and insert a price for this item. Usually, always tax 1 is going to be checked by default, and that's mostly you would want to take care to make sure is checked in your case. If you do have other taxes that are relevant to your business, you can check those down here as well. And the number in stock is really related to the number of these items that we have in inventory. For our purposes today, we're not going to track that, so we're going to leave that set to 0. Now we are going to come down to the box here that says count this item, and we're going to uncheck that. And what that means is that it's not going to deplete inventory on this item when we make a sale of it. And this is still going to record the number of items that we're selling here. So for revenue purposes, we're not excluding this item from sales, simply from the depletion of inventory. And once we're done programming this, there's one other feature that we want to point out before we move on, which is how we would attach kitchen printers, remote printers, or kitchen displays to this item, so that when this item is rung up, it would actually fire off to a remote printer, fire off to a kitchen display monitor. We're going to just touch on this briefly. So to do that, we would click on the printers tab over here, and this gives us options to add printers and add monitors to the list. We're not going to go into great detail right here. There's going to be another training video on this that you're going to want to find and review. But for the moment here, if we wanted to fire off to kitchen printer one, or let's say that we wanted this to fire off to monitor number one, then you would apply those here. If you don't do this when you're in the middle of programming, you have to go back and do this later. There's no shortcut, so just be aware that this is here, and make sure that you check out the other videos if you have questions on this. Now that we've set the item up the way that we're wanting to set it up as a standard item, let's click Save, and the system's going to ask us, do we want to create another item? We can select yes, and that's going to give us a default template again where we have to go through and make the adjustments. If we want to keep the same settings in terms of like the department or the printers that are assigned, the price and the basic naming conventions of the item number and description, we could actually click duplicate last, and we'll talk about that here in just a minute. For now, we're just going to select no because we're done making our standard item, and let's go ahead and click exit and exit again back to the main screen. We'd like to actually add that item to a invoice real quick and watch how it operates, but we don't even see the item here on the screen at this time. In fact, we don't even see the department that we had just created. The reason this is because when we create departments and items, a lot of times the system has to update and refresh the screen. The way that we get that to occur is we're just going to exit out of the software, back to the main login screen. You don't have to turn it completely off, and then just log back in real quick. And now we're going to see the two additional departments that we just created, coffee and bagels, and we're going to see our cafe latte item right here on the screen under the coffee department. So we want to click this item to ring up a sale for an invoice just to see how it operates for the cashier. We're going to run into a little problem when we click on that. It's going to tell us that we must open a shift before we can ring up transactions. And so we just want to click OK here. And the way that you start a shift is clicking the quick key down here that's called start in shift, and it's going to tell us to enter a starting drawer amount. And so, you know, we're going to go ahead and put in a little entry here just to get started. It's going to ask us if we're sure we're done counting. Let's click yes to that, and now we're open and ready for sale. Now we can click our cafe latte standard item, add it to the invoice, and then go ahead and make payment of that item just to see the workflow. This is what the cashier screen looks like. We have some standard pricing denominations at the bottom. We're going to be able to key in exact amounts tendered to us, and also we can pick the tender type when we're making a transaction. In this case, we're just going to cash this transaction out, and this is kind of the workflow that the cashier is going to experience with a standard item.